Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today I'm going to walk you through the really simple procedure to remount the lower unit to our 40 horsepower Mercury Tracker. It's not that tough to do. Let me grab a couple of tools and then I'll walk you through it. It's important that you have at least one of these bolts nearby or within arm's length. It's also very important to make sure that you have it in neutral. Otherwise, the shift shaft is not going to be long enough to go up through the hole inside the midsection. The lower unit will bottom out just by you pushing into it to the midsection of the power head. Do not use one of the bolts to pull it into position. If it will not bottom out, that tells you that there's a problem and something's not lining up correctly. So don't force it. Now let's go ahead and torque down those four, and we need to take it to 40 foot-pounds. The trick with these two is how do you torque these, because they're, well, tucked up under here and there's no way for the torque wrench to fit. Well, this little tool from Motion Pro actually allows you to use a standard box wrench held at 90 degrees to do the tightening. Now that we've got all the bolts torqued down, we need to address the shift shaft. And remember, it is actually broken in the middle, and you have to reconnect it and then reattach these two jam nuts to hold it in place. All right, guys, that's going to wrap this one up. Now I just need to find a boat to hang this on. Well, listen, if you need these parts or anything else for your boat, why don't you come see us at Boats.net, and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.